world's so bright. It's hard to breathe, but that's alright. Hush.
How's it going, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of Star Wars The Old Republic Imperial Agent Edition. And in this episode, we are headed to Alderaan. So without further ado, let us go.
Stand by. I'm routing comm traffic through our midrim outposts. You're on a 6-second delay until I resynchronize the data stream. 3, 2, 1. Synced and secured. Tracking systems show you're in the castle lands of Alderaan. Enjoy the view, Cypher. I hear the mountains are lovely.
After the last few worlds, I'll be sure to appreciate it.
It'll keep you sane. Alderaan is governed by the wealthiest noble families in the galaxy. They've feuded for centuries, and are presently engaged in a full-scale war. You're here because Imperial Intelligence believes that one of the noble houses, or a noble within one of the houses, is financing the Eagle's Terror Network.
What sort of financing are we talking about?
Money for weapons, transportation, bribes, anything the cells need. The Empire's resources are tied up supporting House Thul's efforts to claim the throne. But Intelligence does have one asset, Vector Hillas. Vector was an Imperial ambassador to the nobles, but he was later repurposed. Now he's with the Killix, Alderaan's native alien species.
You think this Vector knows something useful?
He's an expert on the political situation, but I should explain. When Vector approached the Killix on a mission of diplomacy, they absorbed him into their collective intelligence. He's part of their hive mind. However, he continues to file activity reports, and we believe he's still loyal to the Empire, even if he's barely human anymore.
So what's our next step?
We've requisitioned Vector from the diplomatic service and given him a need-to-know overview. Your rendezvous at these coordinates. Use him to eliminate any noble or house funding the terrorists. Watcher 2 out.
Alright, so we are headed to Alderaan to find Vector, the hive-minded Keelik wannabe. As my dog so carelessly eats in the background once again. At this point, it's just expected. Yeah, you freaking plan this, don't you, dude? It's like, yep, I just wait till you start recording and then I go eat. I decide I'm hungry only then. Freaking little douchebag. Lucky, I love you. Now he's just like staring at me like, Oh man. Dogs. Alright, let's see here. We need to go that way. Zoom out a bit. Get on our speeder. Speeder's always nice. Alright, Senor Vector. Looks like you're actually out towards this way. Then again, looks like that might be a simpler route. Or route to take, I guess. Do you guys say route or route? Or route or route? For me, it literally just depends on where I'm at. Like if I'm at Sonic or something, like I want to route 44. But if I'm like on a road trip, I'll be like, oh, I want to take this route or something like that. You know, it's weird. And this is where we need to be. Alright, some Helic Walkers. Helic Drone. This looks like my man.
Yes, this is the one, as the song schedule determined.
I can't wait to see how this goes.
We are Vector Hillis, Dawn Herald of the Ouroboro Nest. Pleased to make your acquaintance, agent.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Cipher 9. I'm with Imperial Intelligence.
Of course. We trust our appearance doesn't disturb you. Our superiors in the diplomatic service find our joining disconcerting, but it was necessary. The joining allowed us to share thoughts and senses with the Nest, forge a bond between Empire and Kilix. The change is a small price.
So long as it gets the job done.
We appreciate your professionalism. Yes, as to your target, Imperial Intelligence provided us with a list of names, dates, and locations connected to your terrorist financier.
Do you have an ID on the target?
We can't identify the financier himself, but your information shows he's visited House Organa, House Ceres, House Pantier, and House Cortes. Cortes is a vassal of the Empire's proxy, House Thule. If you show the Cortes Baron a copy of our findings, he might close in on your foe.
I appreciate the advice.
We must proceed to the Dance of Unlighting, but we'll remain here for the duration of your mission. We suggest you present yourself to Cortes as an ally of the Empire. Show strength, and don't mention your intelligence connections.
Alright, well, you need to go get your eyes checked out, my guy. But in the meantime, we will go meet with this Baron of House Cortes. Question is, how far away is the Baron? He's not too far. Let's go ahead and jump out on our speed up. And we just gotta take it all the way over there, it looks like. Lovely. Random ass freaking glitch in the wall there. Hey Dodger, do you really like feel the need to do that now? I'm about to go put you in the other room. And you go right back to it. You're a douche sometimes. And looks like this is a phase area. Alright. Oh, they got some nice, like, little buildings up in here, I'll admit.
Hold your guard.
Oh, shit.
In the name of Baron Payar Cortes and the Cortes Barony, I demand you state your business or face expulsion.
Huh.
I am one of the free soldiers of the Palemian trade route, come to offer my company services.
Another mercenary thug, then. Come to Alderaan for a few credits.
Best mercenary thug this side of the rim.
Captain Perovius, there's no need to react this way.
Forgive me, my lady.
I am Baroness Che Cortes, Forgive our lack of hospitality, but these are inhospitable times. And quite frankly, Cortes has no need of mercenaries. Friends, yes, but not armies for hire.
Allow me to prove that I can be a friend.
Perhaps. Some days ago, we lost a squad of battle droids patrolling the borders of Cortes lands. That squad was our first line of defense. We believe the squad's disappearance may presage an attack, yet not one of our allies has come to our aid.
That explains a great deal. You have my sympathies, Baroness.
I'm not looking for sympathy. We don't know what destroyed our droids. They went silent. Until we find out, we must prepare for the worst. If you want our favor, send your troops to determine the fate of our patrol. Perhaps then my Baron may host guests.
We'll do everything possible to make this right.
I'll leave you to Captain Perovius. I hope to see you under better circumstances.
If your troops find droids, tell them to activate the squad's homing beacon. Perhaps the data logs will help us.
Alright. So, gotta go activate some droid homing beacons outside. Go ahead and activate that. Put a map away. And go back outside the phase. And it shouldn't be too far in front of us. Well, I say that. Looks like we kinda need to go this way, maybe? Not entirely sure. It kinda looks like we have to go around. Which that in itself is kind of a bummer. Whoa, got some hostiles. Hostile bugs. Okay, here we go. Got a little blue. It's a large influence, so I'll keep that definitely. We gotta click on this droid here.
This is Captain Perovius. It's good to see you again. I'm impressed that you conducted the search personally. We're receiving the droid's logs now. You have my thanks.
No thanks are necessary. It was my privilege.
I would have lost men conducting the search. You saved lives today. At any rate, these logs are discouraging. The droid skirmish with the Killix. Blasted bugs are on Cortes lands again.
I ran into a few more on my way here.
Figures as much. Rumor has it that the Killix nest is growing. Probably scouting for a new home. I'll make sure the Baron knows. Those things won't build a new hive in Cortes territory, I'll tell you that.
I'm sure the Killix will get your message.
Indeed. In the meantime, I have a message for you. The Baroness is offering you an invitation to the estate. You may return at your leisure.
Fantastic. Fantastic. Alright, so with that said, I'm just gonna go ahead and fast travel over there. Because I don't feel like taking the spear. And now, hopefully we can do some business.
The Baron is expecting you. This way, please.
Our guest has arrived, my lord.
Baron Payar Cortes, Sword of the Castle Lands. I hereby present to you an honorable friend and a soldier of fortune. This man risked himself in the service of House Cortes, valiantly recovering our lost patrol and identifying the Killick threat. In appreciation of his noble deeds and out of respect for his accomplishments, I ask that you grant him recognition.
I so grant him recognition. I am Baron Payar Cortes, good sir. Welcome to my home.
Well.
Allow me to present Kaleo Janis, my loyal and trusted associate.
Such an exotic young woman. How is it you come to be here?
I slid out of Mama's womb and picked up a blaster. Now I'm your new friend's bodyguard. Of course, you and me could be friends too. You got a nice place here. I could stick around a while.
Baron?
You are an intriguing creature, I admit.
Hear what he said? That was sweet.
With those manners, you could be royalty.
I could welcome people just like the Baroness.
I hope I didn't give the wrong impression at the gates. I just take the security of my house very seriously.
One of few things she does, along with her gardens and her ack dogs.
You'll make me blush, my lord.
Tell me now, why do you seek my house? Is there a favor you would ask? An alliance you'd propose?
I'm trying to identify a visitor to House Cortes. I know when he was here, but not his name or face.
I'll gladly help. Show me what you have. The dates in your files, yes, we've had visitors at these times, but that's no surprise. I believe the guest you're looking for is Master Denry Ale. We've hosted him and his summits on a number of occasions.
Tell me where to find this man.
Well, it may not be so easy as that. Denry Ale was once Lord Denry Ale, a powerful and respected man among the vassal houses. But some years ago, he abdicated his position.
He became a mediator dedicated to forging peace.
Strange you should ask about him now. For several weeks, Denry Ale has been missing. Whether off on some secret negotiation or something more regrettable, no one knows.
Isn't anyone trying to find him?
Not that I'm aware of. One missing man in all this chaos. But it bears investigation. I'll begin looking into Ale's whereabouts through formal and informal diplomatic channels. If I can find him for you, I will. You may also wish to investigate the matter yourself. I'm sure a mercenary of your caliber has sources.
I appreciate your efforts, Baron.
In the meantime, you're welcome to stay as a guest. House Cortes prides itself on its hospitality.
We'll have to dine together. You can meet the Ack Dogs.
The Baron has spoken. This audience is at an end.
The Baron didn't even say he was done, but okay. Alright, so with that, we can return to Vector. Like, hey man. got some news. Though if it's good or bad, I'm not entirely sure. But news nonetheless. The only downside is the long trip back. It's like cut off one of their legs with like this blade. You could like sharpen like the edge of this thing, just like go up on the side of something, just like cut it down, and just speed past it. Like shank. Back of your leg is gone. Just cut you down, fool. Do like a weird like little turn in midair and just slice you down. Slice you all down. And go so fast that you just like poke yourself into a tree and just get stuck. You're dead. And you're dead. Go up this tree. We can. Alrighty, Vector. Where you be, big boy?
Is it me, or are there more bugs than last time?
Welcome back. Your aura reflects your attunement to the Great Song.
What are all these Killiks doing here?
The Hive requires more nutrients. These are foraging parties. They'll gather what we need.
Are you short on supplies?
We've been depleting resources rapidly this season, but our foragers can compensate. Our observers saw you enter the Cortes estate. The Fingerlings were listening and heard mention of Denry Ale. We met Ale during our time as ambassador. With his wealth and talent, he could be your target.
The Baron claims not to know his whereabouts.
We might be able to help. Our nest has had many joiners over the years. Soldiers, children, nobles. We can search their memories and see what they know of Denry Ale.
Let's see what you come up with.
We remember Pabal Alder. When her speeder crashed, our foragers brought her to the Hive. Our healers tended her. We became one. Her house, House Alder, an old house of scholars and antiquarians, granted Ale residence in honor of his work as a mediator. Ale kept records of his work in the Alder estate. If you can penetrate the estate's defenses, those records are yours.
Good work. I'll have those records in no time.
If we may be so bold. A warning. House Alder opposes the Empire, and the estate is always prepared for an Imperial attack, even a stealthy one. Be careful.
Well, fair enough. Let's go ahead and get on the jetpack. Or boosters. So many bugs. Alright. So from here. Can go ahead and get on one of the flying beasts to get to our next destination.
Vehicle pads are currently open for business.
Like riding it in style. Look at us. Yes, sir. It's like majestic as hell. The Kaamos territory. The Juran Sent. Jump on our speeder. And just follow the route or route or whatever you want to say, the path. The snowy and muddy road. Between those guys. Alright. Oh, we got some more to go by, but shouldn't be that bad. Alright, now that we're in a safe area, we should be able to go. There's not an entrance over here. You can always crash the freaking estate like that. Straight up ninja that. Oh. Hello.
Getting good.
Lovely. Goodbye. Please, thank you. These records consist of appointment calendars, logs of financial transactions, meeting transcripts, and personal notes from Denry Ale's time as a mediator. Much of the information is meaningless with that context, but a few journal entries catch your attention. Entry 56. And with representative of Mindoc family, Drome and Koss agree to purchases, credits to be transferred tomorrow. Entry 62, negotiation successful. As goodwill gesture, House Organa and House Renar agree to 50,000 credits in charitable donations. Both houses concur. I will act as unbiased party in choosing charity. We'll announce decision of Broken Valley Relief Fund, Balmora, tomorrow. At C's suggestion, cancel next week's summit with Thul. Ooh. Attack on DK. Darth Jadis assassinated. Bigger than expected. Glad summit was canceled. Arranged charitable gifts in response to tragedy. At tonight's gala, meet with EE to arrange future visit. Ask about privacy concerns. C suggests secrecy. Interesting. Interesting. So now we gotta go back over Damn, Vector. You want... All that just to look into the databanks, nothing else? Let's get on the speeder. Still lots of Keelix up in here. Oh, he's down on the ground this time.
Agent, it's good to see you. Yes, we apologize. The nest has been invigorated by star dancing. If you could smell the pheromones, you'd understand our restlessness.
This restlessness, is it going to be a problem?
There's nothing to be concerned about. The hive is growing, and we all benefit. We even have a gift for you. These orbs contain white membrosia, rare nectar produced by our givers. Pull back the wax and sip. You'll find it gives strength and healing.
Practical but exotic. I like it.
We hoped you might. In any case, how's the search for Denry Ale?
I found records in the older estate, but I'm not sure what to make of them.
This is perplexing. It looks like Ale funded the destruction of the Dominator and the assassination of Darth Jadus. But the rest is very odd. Have you shown this to Baron Peer?
I was hoping I wouldn't need to.
Baron Peer may see nuances we don't. We've mentioned our difficulty with human personalities. We'll be on alert, should you need anything else. The nest embraces our unity.
Okay then. Well, I think with that, guys, I think we're ending the episode off here. In the next episode, we will go ahead and finish up our time on Alderaan. And yeah, we'll see what happens. So until then, guys, go ahead and leave a like on the episode, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you on the next episode.